No.
Look out for your red one. There we go. I am really scared. But before I address this, let me introduce myself. My name is Bobby Worthy. As y'all know, when you put it all over the paper, I have petitioned the court to change my name to Adil Mustafis Muhammad. Because I said, yes, I said in the media that I was going to get rid of my slave master name. Believe me, Bobby Worthy is not my ancestor's name. To clear that up. And yes, I did say that. But let me explain something to you. Let me give you a little history story that y'all manipulated this story with what happened to me and Larry Neesmith. Me and Larry Neesmith, and is this Ed in here? You're Ed? I sent you a copy of the emails that Larry sent me in July threatening me. So why would you say this has something to do with what happened to me and Larry Neesmith? What happened to me and Larry Neesmith started in July because, let me explain to you, because his pastor we discovered in Homerville, Georgia, was signing illegal bonds. That's how it started with me and Larry Neesmith. Because he said his pastor is a good pastor. But that's not what the Georgia Secretary of State is saying right now. He was signing illegal bonds even in Coffee County. And he didn't have the assets to back him up. That's what started with me and Larry Neesmith when he said, on my Facebook page, said, Bobby Worthy, I'm the wrong one. I'll come see you. So I said, come see me. That was in July. And you try to justify him and my past? Justify him attacking me at the Old Town restaurant? You better be glad you had a bond hearing instead of filming. Because the Georgia Castle Doctor Law gives me that right to protect myself, deadly if necessary. Now let's get it, don't get it twisted and keep it real. He attacked me, and y'all trying to justify him committing a crime? Really? And y'all call yourself journalists? Understand that. So if you want to know the whole history of me and Larry Neesmith, go to my page, Bobby Worthy. I posted everything that he sent me on Facebook back in July. So you'll know how it started with Larry Neesmith. It did not start with this meeting. A matter of fact, Larry Neesmith called her and told her, you better not mess with Bobby Worthy, he trouble. So who was the trouble one? Who attacked me in public? And see, that's what y'all don't know. And I understand the media, y'all are trying to sell a story. But I sent you that, and you should have printed that, where it started. But yet, you say, new militia group, recent altercation shines light on militia group. It had nothing to do with this group.
Nothing
at all. It was Larry D. Smith's ego. They got his ass locked up, excuse my language, but ass in the Bible. Now I'm gonna break down this article for y'all. All right, y'all said in here, you got me standing on the flag. And what you got these people standing on the flag. Please believe me, all the stuff that you go on my page, if you read the whole thing, you'll see the Lord justified. So just like you'll put the flag, the reason I put the thing on the flag, about the flag in there, is because there is no law for you to burn or desecrate the flag. There is no law against that. The Supreme Court has ruled that, and you printed part of that, you should have went in there and read the whole law. It's in there. I didn't rule it. The U.S. Supreme Court ruled it. Now, it's not ethical for us veterans to step on the flag and all that, but I just let that know because people, the case in Valdosta, people were so wildly about this guy walking on the flag. So what is wrong with informing the people of the truth, of their rights, their legal rights? And then you're going to bring up my past. Something happened 30 years ago. Please, I moved on. Y'all suggest y'all do the damn same. Now, y'all call me militant? Yeah, I say some things people don't like. Then you say, then you talk about me. Oh, yeah, you talk about against white people? Really? My mama's white. Now, don't y'all feel ignorant. Hey, I saw that sister. That's all white. Now, don't y'all feel ignorant. You know, like I said, now, Jerry Hudson, now, he printed the stuff about me. But what he did when he added Miss Olivia to it, then that's fine. I don't care if he printed what he printed by me, but I'm pretty sure he got what I printed back. Understand? Racism, a form of racism in this country would not exist me down since the chilling in here.